下面可以提问，你们问的时候简单的问我，问答回答的时候也是比较简单的回答。
Then can proceed can take questions from you, and maybe if you can ask your questions briefly, then Kimpu can answer your question briefly. Then we can take as many questions as possible.
所谓的简单，不是说给我问一个简单的回答的，给我问尖锐的可以，但是时间就是关系，就是所以，不是，就语言就不一定要很长的，就是我的意思。
Briefly, it does not mean some simple question. You can change him. You can ask very sharp questions. but just because of the time, then maybe make it short, then we can do more.
我的问题是关于菩提心跟空性他们之间的关系，因为我们说佛教里面讲，菩提心可以去除所知障，但是我的问题是说，但是要是你去观察中观因缘派他们所讲的道理，那你去观察法，那也可以把法看成变空性嘛。那为什么必须要菩提心才可以去除这些所知障呢？我不知道他们两个真正的就是怎么运用。
它是这样的，那个菩提心呢，就是实际上是，也是需要刚开始的时候发菩提心，然后到最后呢，就是菩提心也是变成一种，这个它的一种大悲心，就是佛陀时代的时候的佛陀成佛的时候一种大悲心，但是真正的烦恼障和所知障去除的对治法呢，不是菩提心来对治的。迪那像苏格尔们就是，就发生轮式的释量论当中呢，就是说我们这个慈悲心呢，就是实际上跟这个烦恼障和所知障呢，并不是直接相位，因为它要去除的话呢，一定要用一种直接与它相位的这种唯品来，就是要断除它。所以我们要断除的是什么呢？断除这些烦恼障和所知障的根本的。这个对治法是什么呢？就是空性智慧。那空性智慧有了以后呢，就是就可以断除这些障碍。断除这些障碍以后呢，你就可以对，因为你自己心里已经产生这个大悲，就这种空性智慧。然后空性智慧呢，就感觉得到，就是身边很多众生呢，就是没有证悟这样的空性，然后对他们也产生就是更加强烈的这种。菩提心，就可以这样理解。还有一种理解呢，就是所谓的菩提心呢，有世俗菩提心和圣意菩提心。而世俗菩提心呢，就是我们现在所谓的这种大悲菩提心，要帮助利益众生的这个心。而圣意菩提心呢，当你获得了一地菩萨以上的这种境界啊，就是一地菩萨以上的这种境界呢。就是叫圣意菩提心，在那个境界当中呢，还是具有我的智慧，就所以呢，这个时候这个圣意菩提心当中呢，有我的这种圣意智慧，就应该是具足的。如果世俗菩提心的话呢，按照发乘轮师的观点，也不能断除，但是我们也没有说是菩提心来断烦恼，没有这么讲。
Can you answer this question in two aspects? The first one is, as a question about the bodhicitta and the emptiness, one of them because he said something maybe different from the Chinese. When we talk about 所知障, it means, or in English it says the cognitive obscuration. But he said something maybe about the objects, the phenomena, that's what he used. So, and Kimpu's answer for this was, so the first one, at the beginning, when we generate bodhicitta, we will reach the great compassion, which the Buddha already obtained when he became the Buddha. However, this compassion is not the direct remedy for our obscuration and either emotional or cognitive emotions. And Dhammakirti, he said in his commentary in this way, so compassion is not the direct remedy for the obscuration. That's what Kenpo quoted. And the thing that can directly counteract with obscuration is the wisdom of emptiness. And if we have this wisdom of emptiness, we can remove all the obscurations, either cognitive or emotional. The other way to answer this question is, when we talk about bodhicitta, there are two kinds of bodhicitta, conventional bodhicitta and the ultimate bodhicitta. When we talk about the conventional bodhicitta, is the great compassion that we have. Then we have the motivation to benefit, to help all other sentient beings. And when we talk about the ultimate bodhicitta, when you reach the first bhumi or the first stage of a bodhisattva, then you realize the emptiness, that wisdom of selflessness. Mm-hmm. And that emptiness can directly work on our obscuration. So mm-hmm. if in that way, then you can see bodhicitta mm-hmm. is helping you to counteract the obscurations.
Mm-hmm. 八风没有断除，再多的修行也是，不是圆满的，不是清净的。但是在我们像我们是在家众修行者，我们没有办法断八风。那在这种情况下，没有断八风的情况下，如果我们继续去修行，怎么样能达到圆满，或者说怎么样能尽快的断八风呢？
断八风，世间八风是吧？
对，世间八风。
嗯，就这种说法可能不对的，就即使没有完全断掉，但是呢，你可以修行的，因为通过修行来断住八风嘛。八风断完了以后，就平息世间八法，就那个时候修行也需要，但是呢，更重要的可能还没有断住八风之前，就是要修行。
Okay, and so her question was, she heard some statement like that. Without remove all your attachment to the eight worldly concerns, mm-hmm. you cannot do your practice. Because even if you try to do your practice without completely remove your eight concerns of the worldly concerns, your practice will not be completed, or you cannot really reach your goal. Mm-hmm. And because as householders or lay practitioners, it's impossible for us to completely remove all our concerns of the eight worldly concerns. If that is the case, how can we start our practice, or how can we reach the completion of our practice? And I think Kimberly said, this statement is incorrect. It's not the case, because while you are doing your practice, you can remove your concerns, or these eight worldly concerns, gradually. Because that is the way, your practice is also the approach for you to remove, to weaken your attachment to these eight worldly concerns. I think basically can be less the case.
We have conflicts of emotions, and they arise and they're very powerful. Intellectually, we understand that there's an attachment to those emotions, and we know that we should be facing them and averting them. But sometimes they're so powerful that we just get carried away, and you know, it takes us up on a wave. What is the simplest way to cut through that when they do arise? What's the simplest way to stop that?
没有特别简单的方法。
There is no simple way.
因为烦恼在我们心里就穿袭的特别多。这样的话，我们要断除它， 一定要有一种强大的这个智慧，还要长期的修行。有一个修行人跟我讲，他刚开始的时候烦恼非常强大，就觉得好像自己精神当中都没有希望。后来就他就先拼命的刻大图，就刻了40万，然后呢就修其他的，我们藏传佛教里面讲的50万加心，就是什么发心啊，就是皈依啊，念白字名啊，就是这些，然后用自己的这种身体和心呢，有一种非常强迫的方式来，就是修了几年，那这个时候就烦恼就是基本上就先就比较平和了，不像以前那么恐怖，然后慢慢就现在呢就是就烦恼就自然而然，就是基本上没有很多产生。我遇到一个修行人，我很相信他的话，所以我们可能像一个很简单的方法来就是做的话呢，有一定的困难，一定要就是下功夫，就是花时间，最后就是将烦恼就是可以断除。
So yeah, like Nicola said, there is no such a most simple way to do that. And this is because all our afflictive emotions, they have been in our mind, they formed in our mind through non-time habitual familiarization. So in order to move them, we do need a lot of time and a lot of effort. It also requires us wisdom to understand it first and then do our practice for a long time. And Kimbula shared a story because there is a very good practitioner shared his practice with Kimbula. He said at the beginning, his afflictive emotions is so strong, he feels there's no hope for him to succeed in his practice. But he decided to do practice. At first, he did 400,000 full-length prostration. And then he did the preliminary practices of the 500,000 generating bodhicitta, taking refuge, and reciting the mantra of Vajrasattva, the 100-syllable mantra. And through this kind of forceful way to do the practice on his body and mind, after several years, his afflictive emotions weakened less. It's not so scary as before, not as so powerful as before. So now, there are not much afflictive emotion that arises in his mind. So there's no simple way. If it's a simple way, it may not be so effective. So we do need to spend a lot of effort, time, then we can remove our afflictive emotions.
I had a simple way. It was like this. But there were repercussions. You can tell.
They come back again.
Yeah, absolutely.